Less than 10 months after admitting to sexual misconduct and vowing to take a long break to reflect on his behavior, comedian Louis C.K. returned to the stage and received a standing ovation. But not everyone is happy that he's back as fierce backlash builds online. CK performed a surprise stand-up show in New York's Comedy Cellar earlier this week. It was his first public appearance since he admitted last year to inappropriate behavior, which included exposing himself in front of female co-workers and comedians. CK's set reportedly included material about familiar topics, like racism and tipping in restaurants, but stayed away from the elephant in the room, as well as anything explicitly related to sex or relationships. While the comedian earned a positive reaction in the comedy club, this early test of whether audiences are willing to forgive him for his misdeeds didn't go over as well on social media. Among the massive online backlash was this tweet from the head writer on The Late Late Show with James Corden, Ian Carmel, who wrote, "Louis C.K. being banished from stand-up comedy wasn't some kind of petty punishment. It was a workplace safety issue." Director Judd Apatow tweeted, "The obvious thing to do when you hurt people and disappear for a while is to return and talk about what you learned and tell people how you are going to help victims and others going forward. This hasn't happened here or with anyone who has been accused." Review aggregation site Rotten Tomatoes is making a vow to showcase a much more diverse range of voices. In a big tomato meter overhaul, the company is making it easier for independent critics to join the platform. This in response to criticism that Rotten Tomatoes ratings were based on a pool of mostly older, mostly white, mostly male critics. Rotten Tomatoes says it's also expanding the reviews it considers from strictly print to include podcast and video reviews as well. This news sounds certified fresh to us. For City News, I'm Teri Hart.